gonna go exploring, Mom. Okay? Okay, just keep away from the pier. It's old.
I will.
Okay, coming. Mom. Hey, Mom, wake up. Wake up. You've been asleep all day.
Okay, Espen. I'm up. Sorry.
Why do you have to stay up so late? You're always tired.
Espen, I came here to work. You were supposed to be with your grandparents this weekend. Sorry. Just let me get some coffee. We'll go night fishing down by the lake or something.
I just wanted to go to the bathroom, but it's dark outside.
I'm sorry. Go get the flashlight and I'll come out with you. Look at the stars, Espen.
You wait right here, won't you?
Of course. So, what do you want to do tonight?
Mom, I'm trying to pee here.
We could make some hot chocolate.
Mom! Go away! Just wait up the path. I can't go while you're standing there.
Okay, little man. If you say so. You done, Espen? Espen? Stop messing around, Espen. I'm not in the mood. I mean it, Espen. Come out. Jesus, Espen. What are you doing?
Sorry.
I thought I'd see if I could scare you after all.
You were getting there. Let's go inside. I don't know if I want to make you hot chocolate anymore.
I was only kidding, I'm sorry. Please, can we have hot chocolate?
Okay, but don't scare me again. And you're washing the cups.
Okay. Hey, can I go down to the pier in the morning? I want to try catch some crabs.
I'm pretty sure you're not going to find any crabs. It's a freshwater lake. Anyway, the pier's broken and dangerous. Please don't go down there by yourself.
Fine. But I still want hot chocolate.
I'm not going to pretend I was a great mother. When Espen was born, I found, to my surprise, I felt nothing. My nightmare had come true, and I was left raising a child I didn't love. My friends became distant, and Espen's father and I began to fight. I resented them both, and one day, Espen and me were alone. But as Espen got older, I slowly began to realize something. I did love him. I loved him so much I ached. He became my best friend, my favorite thing. Then I lost him. We lost each other. And I don't know if I can forgive myself. Or Espen. Espen? Why didn't you wake me up? Espen? Want some breakfast? Or lunch? We have eggs and bacon. Guess he's out playing. I loved our room at the cabin. Espen's reflectors looked nice in the sunlight, and his drawings fascinated me. He soaked up the world, and it bled from his imagination to the page in pastels and pen. The process always seemed to distill the harsh world into something pure. Espen? It's freezing. What is he doing out in this cold? Espen? I hope you're not down by the pier. I told you that thing's dangerous. Espen? Talk to me, little man. Hey! Hey! Get away from my son! Jesus! Jesus! Espen! Get away from him! Espen, I'm coming! Espen! Hello?
There was a folktale in the town where I was born about a man called Old Eric. They said he would sneak into the village at night and steal away children and misbehaved. My parents used to tell me that I had to be good or Old Eric would come and take me. At the time, it didn't even cross my mind that the person in the journal could be the same man from the folktales. But later I wasn't so sure.
Dropped it. I'm coming, Espen!
loved his reflectors. He collected them from magazines and cereal boxes, and I bought him a couple from the gas station by our house. He'd hang them from the curtain pole at the cabin and wave his flashlight over them at night to watch them shine. I could hardly believe any of this was happening, but what I didn't know was the reflector I found was his. What I couldn't know at the time was that he'd left me more, a trail, and that as long as I stumbled across these reflectors now and then, that Espen was still alive.
Espen's flashlight.
No. Espen. Please don't hurt him. Please. Don't you hurt him!
I'm coming, Espen. I'm coming. Espen must be cold without his jacket.
When I saw Espen's jacket there on the ground, it felt like something inside me broke. I suddenly realized that this was really happening. He had been taken from me. His coat. His little coat lying in that dark place. I was his mother. I was supposed to protect him. He trusted me, and I let him down, as I had so many times before. His jacket was a symbol of my failure. I promised myself I would find him and bring him back. I just hoped that was a promise I could keep.
The smell. Some photos of my parents in an old shoebox at their house. I was looking for Christmas presents. They looked so young and in love before I was born. I remember they didn't look like the people I thought I knew. There was something different about them I couldn't understand. I was lifting a veil, and I knew these pictures were not for my eyes. The island was like that. The journals, the troll, the broken moon. I wasn't supposed to see those things. I was intruding on something secret, and I didn't belong there.
There's another reflector. Espen, you're alive. Don't be scared, little man. I'm coming.
out of your eyes, woman. I told you we can't stop it.
Don't put an end to it. I will. They'll not take our girl.
There are other girls. The old bastard may even come for ours. I'll not let you put us all in danger.
Devil take ye, you craven bastard. Oh, let me go, coward. Why? Let me go.
Ah. You stabbed me. Ah. You're horny.
Hello? But they were here. I heard them. This paper is so old.
Younger, his father did something terrible to Espen, to me, to himself. I was left all alone with a child I couldn't confide in. He didn't give me the chance to say I was sorry, and I never forgave him. But in the forest, I was alone again, desperate for the person I loved the most. And right then, I could almost understand why Espen's father did what he did.
Open the door. I need to find my son. God damn, where is my son?
The children are gone, Eric. All gone.
I'm not Eric. I think he has my son. Who is he? What's he going to do?
If Eric has your son, Wanderer, there'd be no hope for him.
Now get you from my door!
Hello? Excuse me. My son's been taken, and I just...
Oh, you're too late, bastard! Too late! It's done!
Huh? I'm looking for my son. An old man with a white beard took him, and I think they came this way. Please, have you seen them?
It's done! Don't you see? Ye whore son! Ye shan't take her from me now, Eric! Ye shan't take her!
I don't know what you're talking about. I'm not Eric. I won't touch your daughter. Who is he? Does he have my son? Please, I need to know!
The wolf! Ye simpering bitch! The wolf! The bastard was to take my little one to appease the great wolf. But I sent her on with a kiss. I sent my little girl on.
Oh my God. Please, don't tell me that's your daughter.
Look what you made me do! Look at her! Ye hateful bitch! My baby! My beautiful
boy! Oh, Christ! No!
I had to do it. Tell me I had to. Bastard! Bitch! The wolf will never accept a child so cold. Please. Please.
My heart started to harden. I was still frightened and scared. I felt small and alone, but I was also angry. This man, Eric, had taken my son. He lured Espen away while I slept, and it wasn't the first time. He had poisoned the whole island. He was dangerous. I didn't know what I was going to do when I caught up to them. I just knew I wasn't going to let this man take one more child.
Some creature? He couldn't have meant it. Child sacrifice? Oh my god. Espen, I have to find him.
Thank you.
cliche, but I thought monsters were just in books and movies. In our dreams. But on the island, there were monsters everywhere. That blind creature, it almost killed me. The horrific thing in the cave. And Eric had taken my son. I wanted to hurt them all. I wanted to just... I wanted them to be scared. Does that make me a monster too? There, forgotten by everyone. When my father died, we buried him and we mourned him. I told Espen he was in a better place and to remember his grandfather as he was before he got sick. Who was mourning these people? Where were they remembered fondly? It seemed like the people on the island had been fighting to hold on for so long, then just go. But I wasn't ready to let go. I wasn't ready to let Espen become a memory.
that sound? Dangerous.
Thank you.
Eric's house. Maybe Espen's inside. Did he hurt you?
Mom, I'm fine.
You're sure?
Yes.
Okay, come on. We have to get out of here right now.
Mom.
He could be back any minute. I think we just have to run.
Mom!
Don't want to get cornered in here.
Mom, listen to me!
What? We have to go!
Mom, I'm not going.
Huh? What do you mean?
I can't go with you, Mom. I left the trail for you so I could say goodbye.
Espen, you don't know what he's going to do. I've seen things, read things. I think he's going to try to...
I know, Mom. I know what he's gonna do. And what I have to do.
Espen?
He's coming.
Quick, hide!
You should not have come here.
You took my son. You're a murderer. You take children from their homes.
The fate I suffer is not one I enjoy, nor is it one I have any choice in.
The fate you suffer? What about these children? All these children?
They are chosen. They must come. Some of them, like your brave son, even choose to come.
They're children, you fucking monster! They should decide if they live or die! You lied to them! Lured them!
I don't lie. I only tell them what must happen. There's no time for this. Sunrise draws near. Espen, we must leave.
Get back! Don't you touch
him! Mom, it's okay. It's going to be okay. No, don't hurt her!
Run, Espen! Run!
You cannot protect him any longer.
Mom! Mom! No! Mom! Mom!
I'm sorry.
Espen? Oh, bastard. Better take that key.
Kjenner du ei min?
Jeg kjenner noe varm og gredd yver oss.
Blodrinn bedre om det jeg bra med deg.
Jeg og. Lenge siden jeg og noe eikaren har i. Jeg mjøk svanger av flesk.
Vil du veide, broder?
Vær veidum.
Yeah.
Please, I just want to find my son. I can hear you talking. Do you understand me? Please, don't kill me. I know about you. I know you're trapped here. Island. I just want to find my son.
Very well. We have an agreement. The key opens the door behind you. Go and open it. We will remain here. Then you may leave.
Huh? That's it? How do I know you won't just kill me afterwards?
You don't. But neither do you have a wealth of options. If you would prefer to stay here, you may. We are unable to die, so we shall see who sees first. Besides which, we understand you have somewhere you wish to be, come son up. You may decide.
Fine. But if one of you comes near me, I am going to throw this key, and good luck unlocking this door with your paws.
I wish I could forget it all again.
man. Help me.
Holy shit. Hello?
Human. I have waited. My mistress.
Jesus. What are you? How are you still alive? There's nothing left of you.
I am Garm. Guardian of the gates. Guardian of hell. The veiled lady. I was those things. Too old. Too weak. Unimportant. Help me.
The veiled lady is Hale? Are you really saying Hale is out here somewhere? I don't know how I can help you.
End my suffering. My despair.
You want me to kill you? I can't do that.
The rock above. The spire. Bring it down upon me. Please. Thank you, gods.
Poor creature. You have one just like it at home. Come on.
Mom! I want it!
Listen to your mother now, Espen.
Espen, you're not having it. Let's go.
I want this, Mom!
No! Come here!
Mom! Oh, Mom!
Jesus, what did you do?
Espen, I'm so sorry. I'm sorry, Espen.
No. Please. Why are you doing this? I didn't mean it!
You have to tell them what happened.
No. For God's sake. If we tell them what I did, I'll lose the firm. They'll take Espen away.
We have to. It's the right thing to do.
Please, please don't say anything. It was an accident. I didn't mean it.
I know. It just feels wrong.
Yes, but we'll get through it. Let's just get through it together. Okay? I love you.
Please stop. Please. I didn't mean it. Don't show me anymore.
Want a what?
A divorce, goddammit. I want a divorce.
Here it is at last. Fine. You're welcome to one. But I'm taking Espen.
You're not taking my son!
Well, I'm not leaving him with you. You broke his arm, for Christ's sake.
When will you stop holding that over my fucking head? It was an accident. An accident! And you've looked at me every day since like I'm some kind of monster.
I'm telling you now, if you want a divorce,
no.
Espen is coming with me.
You bitch! Please stop it! Quit. Give up. Just don't show me anymore.
She's lying. I never hit her or Espen. I swear, please. Silence. Sit down now.
I find in favor of the plaintiff, Miss Dahl. She shall retain sole custody of her son, Espen Dahl. The defendant shall have no visitation rights, and a permanent restraining order comes into effect immediately. You, sir, are to have no contact with your ex-wife or Espen whatsoever, and must keep a minimum distance of 200 feet from them, their home, Espen's school, and her place of work. Court is adjourned. No, please, goddammit, let go of me, don't! Please, don't take him away from me. Don't take him away from me!
Please, I'll stop. Eric can have him. I can't. I don't want to see what comes next. Please don't.
Miss Dahl, can we come in? You should sit down. There's no easy way to say this, so I'll just say it. Your husband was found dead in his apartment this afternoon.
Oh, God. Oh, no.
Right now, we're working on the assumption of suicide, but we're investigating. You're safe now. You and Espen are finally safe.
I'm so sorry. I wish I could take it back. It's the worst thing I've ever done. And I loved him. I did. I loved my son, too. I would have done anything to keep him close. I just had no idea his father would... that he... I made one terrible mistake, and I ruined everything. I'll never forgive myself.
Are you happy now, you bitch?
The sun is starting to come up. I'm not going to make it. Holy Christ! Oh my God! The wolf is real!
Espen, look at me! I missed you too, little man. Please come away from the edge.
I have to do this, Mom. Do you understand?
No. Espen, you don't. There are other children. It doesn't have to be you. Shut your mouth, you fucking coward.
Mom, he's just doing his job. He's been protecting us, all of us. Look at him. He doesn't want to do it.
Espen, I love you. And I'm proud of you. Very brave. But I don't want you to do this. Please. Please. I need you.
I love you, Mom. And I'm proud of
Espen.
You, too.
Espen!
No, don't.
Espen, no!
Make sure his sacrifice meant something.